Brett Kavanaugh has told the world that he likes beer. He really, really likes beer. The president today says he, meaning the president, never touches the stuff. In fact, he says being a teetotaler is one of his best qualities.
I'm not a drinker. I can honestly say I never had a beer in my life, okay?
Right.
It's one of my only good traits. I don't drink. Whenever they're looking for something good, I say, I never had a glass of alcohol. I've never had alcohol. I've just, you know, for whatever reason. Can you imagine if I had? What a mess I'd be? Would I be I'd be the world's worst. But I never drank. I never drank, okay?
So Michael D'Antonio is an expert on all things Trump. He's a Trump biographer and the author of the book, The Truth About Trump. Good evening.
Good evening.
But his brother, Fred, had an issue with alcohol, and so Trump vowed never to touch the stuff, right?
It is one of the most profound incidents in Donald Trump's early life, and I think it stuck with him forever.
Were you surprised at that?
Not at all.
What do you mean by it'd be the worst?
Oh, I think he imagines he'd be out of control. I actually think he's a bit phobic about alcohol, and I think he's right that he would be worse than he is were he a heavy drinker. But I think the thing that bothers him more about Kavanaugh is the nominee's hypocrisy. Now, Donald Trump is someone who's made being honest about who he is a virtue. He
right.
insists on telling us how awful he is, and then he is awful, and we're not surprised. Kavanaugh depicted himself as a choir boy, and I think this would really bother Donald Trump even more than the drinking issue, and the drinking issue is big.
That's what I was going to say. So you think the president watching, because everybody's watching, right?
Yes,
everybody
yes.
in the administration was watching him saying over and over and over again, oh, I like beer, I like beer, I like beer. Do you think that bothers the president?
Oh, yes. And I also think that he was watching the histrionics. You know, this was a man who was nearly hysterical as he was testifying. That's not Donald Trump either.
Yeah.
Trump likes a strong man. You know, Mike Pence talks about Donald Trump's broad shoulders. This was not a broad shoulder performance that Kavanaugh gave us.
Yeah, and being made fun of on Saturday Night Live, and you know, as someone who was sort of sniveling, like, and right?
Yes,
not
yes.
good.
And that's what gets to the president about his attorney general. He doesn't like seeing Saturday Night Live. He never watches it, but he happens to be able to comment on it all the time.
And he hosted it.
I mean, it's ridiculous. He watches it every Saturday, I'm sure.
Yeah.
He's watching to see if they talk about him.
Yeah.
And I think this impression that Kavanaugh left distressed the president enormously.
Let's talk more, because you've been, you're his biographer. As I said, you're an expert on all things Trump. Here he is, this is talking about his brother Fred. This is during the 2016 election.
He knew he had a problem, and he was one of my truly great teachers, my father and my brother. I say that all the time. My brother, because of this and other things, but he'd say, don't ever drink, don't ever drink. And I've never had a drink. I mean, I've never had a glass of alcohol, and yet I own the largest winery in the East Coast. It's a crazy thing, but that's okay. but my brother was so instrumental in probably shaping my life, because I just don't know what the outcome would have been.
Speaks very highly of his brother, and obviously it was something that touched him, right?
Mm-hmm.
Here's my question is, does he, though, look down on people who may have a problem with alcohol? Because for him, this is just me thinking, it's either one or the other. Either you don't drink it or you have a problem. There's no in between.
I think you're like correct.
So how does he feel about people who just may have a social...
I think he looks down on anyone who partakes. And I think it's because he doesn't know very much about alcohol. You know, his discussion of this idea of blackouts and, you know, what it means for someone to drink, he doesn't have a sophisticated understanding of it. And as a result, he dismisses it out of hand. And you're either good or bad in his book. And this is bad. This is very bad.
Yeah. Michael D'Antonio, thank you for your time. I appreciate it.